Now let's proceed to the next paragraph for the explanation. Says the ant to the cricket, I'm your servant and friend, but we ants never borrow, we ants never lend. But tell me, dear cricket, did you lay nothing by when the weather was warm? Quoth the cricket, not I. Now, hearing to the cricket, the ant replied that he considers himself cricketer's servant as well as a friend. However, the ants neither borrow anything nor lend anything from others. When did he say so? When the cricket went to the ant for the help. So what she replied? That she considers, means the ant consider herself or himself, whatever it is, cricketer's servant as well as friend. But the ants neither borrow anything nor lend anything from others. Okay. So saying this way, the ant asked the cricket, did he collect or gather food for the crisis when the weather was warm or familiar? To what was his reply? What he said? Quoth. Quoth means said. He said that he did not collect any food or any food grain for the crisis. Now next. My heart was so light that I sang day and night, for all the nature looked gay. After hearing the ant, so the cricket replied when she asked that, did he not collect any? Yeah, why did he not collect any food grains for the crisis? The cricket replied to that, that his heart was so light, means he was so happy and he did not care about the future. The cricket says further that he kept singing day and night all the time as all the nature looked very joyful. He thought that the situation will never change and will remain the same. Food will remain always there. Therefore, he never cared about the future crisis. You sang, sir, you say, go then say the ant and dance the winter away. When the ant listens all this from the cricket, he suggested, means the ant suggested the cricket, that when he sang and enjoyed during the spring and summer, then now he should continue singing and enjoying in winters too. And the winters will also pass away easily. Okay. Thus ending, the hastily lifted the wicket. See the meaning? Hastily means hurriedly, quickly, and lifted the wicket. This is very, very important phrase. It means giving end to the play. So let me elaborate the meaning in reference with this phrase to this chapter. It means especially in a cricket game when one is out of his batting chance, it means that the wicket is gone. Similarly, in this line, the ant refuses to help the cricket and gives an end to the conversation. Okay. Thus ending, he hastily lifted the wicket and out of the door turned the poor little cricket. Folk call this earth fable, I will warrant it true. Some crickets have four legs and some have two. So these two lines are very, very important. So when he suggested the cricket that he should not discontinue his dancing and singing, and season will pass away, okay, happily. Afterwards, the ant hastily lifted the wicket, means ended the conversation with the cricket and push the poor cricket out of the door. Okay. Now the last two lines are very, very important in the poem, as there rests the meaning of the poem. In the last two lines, the poet says that folks, means people in general, call the story of ant and cricket a fable, means an untrue story. Means the people, local people, calls the story untrue story. However, he, means the poet, thinks that the story is quite true. It is quite true because there are many crickets with four legs as well as with two. That is, there are humans like cricket, human beings like cricket, who don't care about their future. Here, crickets with two legs are referred to human beings who don't bother about their future. And repent means feel regret when the time is gone. In other words, they don't make hay while sunshine. So that's all about the explanation of the poem. Thank you so much.